Or you are a visitor, friend, for your very first time at the meeting, I'm going to ask you to stand if you can and will. If you're a friend or visitor, or you are here to witness the ceremony, excuse me, of a loved one that should stand. I see people standing, friends standing all around. Now, by way of family, will you give them a by faith welcome to the mission? Can you give just a little bit more of a welcome to our friend? We're glad you're here. Now this time, without further saying, we say again respect and give honor to all of our leaders and this awesome leadership board and all of our family here today. We thank God for what God has done.
Yeah. you to get up, and you will hear someone say, give an honor to God, who is in heaven of my life. I'm glad to be saved, sanctified, and filled up with His Holy Ghost.
Testify, God is mountain. of this message is this day. Rejoice in the Lord. Say it with me, rejoice in the Lord. Did you notice, and this point has already been made, and let me just remind us that the Lord didn't just say rejoice. If you say to someone rejoice, and to put a mandate on it, and not to give clarity into what we're to be rejoicing in, it's really not a fair command. It's not a fair mandate to just say rejoice and leave it there. But the apostle said rejoice in the Lord, and then he says always, and then he's repeated. He says, and again I say rejoice. This theme of rejoicing is not just the theme of our assembly. It is the theme of the entire book to the Philippian church.
Yes.
Another verse that had been raised a couple of times, I heard previous speakers, Philippians 3:1 says, finally, my brethren, rejoice in the Lord. To write the same things to you, to me indeed is not grievous, but for you it is safe. What do you mean it is safe for me to repeat and impress and command and mandate that you rejoice? How do you see safety in that? The New Living Translation, it is rendered this way. Paul says, I never get tired of telling you these things. I never get tired of telling you to rejoice. I never get tired of telling you to rejoice. Some of you perhaps are tired of the theme. Feel like that we've gotten all the mileage out of it that's to be had. Paul says, I never get tired of telling you to rejoice. I do it to safeguard your faith.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I do it to safeguard your faith. What does my faith have to do with my rejoicing? We've said it. I've heard it. We declare that the joy of the Lord is my strength. I believe this, that really, ultimately, what the enemy is after is our faith. There is not one in this room that is able to go through life or their Christian experience without challenge. Without circumstances, issues, hurts, disappointments, things that will steal your joy. And if we think that these joy is important in the believer's life, it's important in our stability, because he says it is safe for you. It safeguards, yes, your faith.
Yeah.
Evidently, Paul realized that joy does not come easy all the time. Which is why in this book he's so repetitive. He said, you know, not only throughout the book, but even in this theme verse, he says, rejoice in the Lord. Then he says, always, and again, I say, I want to repeat it. Rejoice.
Yes.
One of our messengers noted that rejoicing is not a human emotion. Joy is not just a feeling. But joy is deep down confidence that God is in control of everything. And that all things are working together for our good and for His glory. The word rejoice is kairo, which is a present imperative calling for a lifestyle of joy that emanates from an active choice of our will regardless of our circumstances.
Yes.
Note that I said it's a present imperative.
Yes.
It is an imperative. It is a present imperative, which means it's always present, regardless of our circumstance, that you live a life of joy.
Yes.
That emanates from an active choice of your will.
Yes.
Your faith is involved. You can't fake rejoicing. There are those that will, and perhaps that, let me just go there. Don't see why would we really have a convention theme, one word, rejoice, and folks will say, well, I don't need to hear that. That ain't helping me. I got joy. I'm rejoicing. But if joy emanates from within, it actually produces a change in your countenance.
Yes. Yes, it does.
Don't tell me you have joy and look mad all the time. Don't tell me you have joy and you hard to deal with. You don't want to be bothered. You seem distant. You seem aggravated with people. It's hard for you to embrace any program. You're not excited about praise. You're not excited about vision. You don't care much about. And yet, if you're pushed in a corner, if you're challenged, you'll push back and say, I got joy. Rejoicing is something that radiates, and you can't fake it. Let's be honest, joy, rejoicing is hard sometimes. It's hard. That's why Paul writes this letter. And he repeats it over and over and over again. Rejoice, rejoice, rejoice. It's safe for you. It's safeguarding your faith. Rejoicing is for you. Rejoicing is about you. Rejoicing is not about what they did, said, or done. Rejoicing is about you. I'm telling you to rejoice for you. Not for you to make me happy. Not for you to... He says you rejoice because you got to safeguard you. You need to understand that if the enemy can press your spirit, come on, if he can press down and steal your joy, he steals your strength.
Spirit. can't tell you how many Christians that are dying with this horrific disease. And we're going to pray against. Before I came to church this morning, I was praying for a family to say, I don't want to fight cancer for the third time. I've already fought it twice. And I'm going to pray that the spirit of cancer be extracted. I don't know whether it's in our food, our water. But Satan is allowing something to get in our bodies, to eat up our health. And I want God to move it at the root. As we get ready to pray, can the audience join somebody here? For the word by which we heard from our presiding bishop, Bishop James E. McKnight, Jr. First of all, I want you to cover his body and his spirit from what he has released in this place. Build a shield around him to where no weapon formed against him will prosper. I pray now in the name of Jesus for our Bishop Emeritus, that you build a shield around him. And I pray for my mother that you build a shield around her. Pray for Mother Brown to build a shield around them. Daddy Rourke, nor all our ruling elders and their wives, build a shield around them. Satan, the Lord rebuke you. The blood of Jesus is against you. I thank you for my shalom. I command in the name of Jesus. We pray for Venezuela. We pray for Puerto Rico, that you stabilize that nation and that country. We pray for nations all over the world. For China, Japan, Korea, Australia, Jamaica, the Bahamas, England, and Russia. We pray for the United States of America. From the Church of God by faith, we pray for our nation. For you said in your word that my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray, turn from their wicked ways and seek my face. Then we'll hear from heaven and you will heal our land. Heal the United States of America. I shall do all bullshit. We come against corruption. We come against every demonic plot. We come against separatism. We come against division. But you said in your word that the earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof. Now, God, we speak in the name of Jesus. We bind every demon of cancer. We bind every disease in our blood. Sickness is not from God. We say according to the word of God that by your stripes we are healed. But God don't heal us and not save us. The Bible says the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it and we are safe. Save our children. Save our grandchildren. We bind every generational curse. We come against every stronghold. We don't wrestle against flesh and blood, but we come against the principalities of darkness. We come against the evil rulers in this world. We cast down every wicked imagination. We pull down every stronghold, and we speak deliverance in the name. second request came up. I wanna pray for every bleeding pastor. That's a hurting pastor. It's hard to pastor and you bleeding. And it might take a little strength for you, but we pray for every wounded pastor and every wounded pastor's wife. First Lady, Dolores McKnight, from the top of her head to the sole of her feet, you picked her to be the number one intercessor for our bishop. Cover her with strength. Cover her with strength. Cover her with strength. And give her everything she needs. In Jesus' name, I pray. For our Bishop Emeritus and my mother. Cover them with strength. Satan, you will not have their joy. Cover Mother Maxine and Mother Brown. You cannot have their joy. Cover Daddy Rook. I know it's probably a difficult time for him this time. Give him strength. Sometimes people, you have to think where other people are. We speak strength. Sometimes it takes power to show up.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
We speak strength. I'm moving out of the way. What a word from the Lord.